Israelis have agreed to meet you.
What?
The Israelis have agreed to meet.
When?
Tomorrow.
They're flying Tom home tomorrow.
I know. We can rearrange the flight.
Why should we?
Anthony, you've been asking for a meeting from day one.
What's their agenda?
Does it matter?
They finally agree to meet on the very day they know we're leaving. Does their contempt know no bounds?
They'll have their agenda, but you'll have yours. And you wanted a meeting.
When it would have meant something. I have all the eyewitness testimony and data I need to write my report. It's too little, too late.
I want to see the whites of their eyes.
You wanted to take Tom home the day you arrived.
We can rearrange the flight.
Mr. and Mrs. Hurndall, my name is Danny Camon. I am the representative of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. This is Major Beaton of the IDF.
Okay. As you can see from the sketch, your son would not have been in the direct line of fire from the watchtower.
Not if he was where you claim he was standing when he received his injury, but I have affidavits from 14 eyewitnesses and photographic evidence that show he wasn't shot there.
Why did you take so long to meet with us? My family have been shattered. We have 4 children. They were very, very close. But now 3 of the children are in London by themselves while their brother Tom lies in an Israeli hospital. In a coma, as he has done for the last 2 months. Do you not understand that your refusal to meet with us until the day we were due to fly Tom home offends all common decency?
Perhaps we should have made contact sooner. It's something we might need to review.
As well as requesting voice recordings between the soldiers in the watchtower and their commanding officer, we're making a formal request for CCTV footage shot from the tower at the time of Tom's shooting.
As far as the CCTV footage is concerned, I can say that this would be of no use because we don't have cameras in that position.
I have photographic evidence that you do.
I meant that the cameras are not looking down into Rafah. The cameras in that position are facing the other way.
The other way?
Yes.
The other way is towards the Egyptian border?
Yes.
The second intifada was accorded the status of a war, was it not?
The first intifada had the status of a police action, but then the Palestinians started to target Israeli civilians with suicide bombers.
So you'd consider the current situation to be a war between Israel and Palestinian nationalists?
Not nationalists, terrorists.
In the occupied territory?
In the disputed territory.
With the very worst of the fighting taking place in Gaza?
Yes.
Indeed, in Rafah itself?
At the moment, yes.
So you want us to believe that during this war in Gaza, during which Palestinian terrorists routinely fire on Israeli observation posts and routinely try to sneak up on them in order to blow them up, that your cameras are facing in the opposite direction?
Mr. Hurndall.
Towards Egypt?
Mr.
With whom Israel has been at peace since 1978?
Mr. Hurndall, we are not in a court of law.
Not yet, Mr. Carmen, not yet.
Hello.
Is that Jocelyn Hurndall?
Yes.
Your Arab-loving son got what he deserved.
I beg your pardon?
Palestinians are Jew-murdering scum. I hope your son rots to
death. Who is this?
Fucking Nazi. They sit him up from time to time to drain the fluid from his lungs.
Oh. Bloody hell. Foreign Office rang. They want to represent my report to the Israelis, give it their full backing.
That is fantastic news, Anthony.
Doesn't mean the Israelis will have to pay any attention, of course.
Make it harder to ignore.
I don't know. They've been ignoring UN resolutions for the past 30 years. A report by private citizens shouldn't prove too taxing.
Oh, Anthony, if you really believed that, then you wouldn't have gone to the effort you have.
I owed it to Tom. We made a good team. I don't just mean in Israel. Sorry. You know, when I first heard the news, my first reaction was anger. And then I thought, gosh, Tom, if you're gonna go, then I can't think of a better way for you to go than in an act of great compassion and bravery. And humanity. I couldn't be more bloody proud of you.
Better get back to the office.
Anthony. It's brilliant news.